Hey guys, welcome to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Meg, and if you are a returning viewer, welcome back. So today, I thought it would be a great idea to finally do a review, which is long overdue, for this bag right here. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the Loewe Small Puzzle Bag in the color Midnight Blue / Black in green calfskin with gold hardware, right? At first glance, if you don't have anything black that is contrasting against this bag, you wouldn't really be able to tell that this isn't in fact black, but it is midnight blue. Now the handles, okay, the handle is black, right? The zip pulls, because there's two of them, are black, and also the long strap that comes with it is black, but they all have contrast white stitching on them. Okay. I first saw this bag from Anna, the Anna Edit. Okay. Now you're probably thinking, how come your bag isn't slouching like all the other bags? And I'm like, because I always have an air bubble or an air pillow inside to keep it shape. But when it's not, when it doesn't have it, it does slouch a little bit, especially when it's kind of full. It goes like that. Anyway, so I actually tried to look this up on the Loewe website to give you like the descriptions, but it's no longer there, so I am assuming that they no longer make this color combo. But I do really like it because it is not as loud and it's very understated. Even the anagram that's on there, now some of the Loewe pieces would have this in contrast white, but I prefer this one that's just simply embossed because it doesn't shout Loewe. Like, it's the kind of thing that if you know, you know. It's the kind of brand that if you know, you know. If I want to go out with a designer bag but not draw attention to myself, this is the bag that I take. It's also deceivingly spacious. Okay. So speaking of space, let me just give you the details. So the base length, it says 9.5 inches, which is actually 24 centimeters. Okay, height is 6 inches. I don't know what that is on cm. Multiply by 2.5 is probably approximately about 14 cm, I would say. And then the width is 4 inches, which is roughly about 9 cm, I believe, 8 or 9. Yeah. Now this handle drop, it says, is 2.25 inches between here and there, so that's roughly about 5 or 6 cm there. And then the long strap, when attached, has a drop of 15 inches, or what's that, roughly 40 cm, I'd say, roughly. Yeah, but that obviously depends on where you have that button. Yeah, I guess. where you have that, because there's several of them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 slots for you to be able to 1, 2, 3, 4 on the small. There's only four slots. Okay. Hardware is gold on this one. There's Loewe also makes these in silver. Okay, right. And the bag itself inside, so there's this flap that covers the zip, which also makes it a little bit more secure, but can also be kind of annoying. So inside, let's take out the air pillow. Sorry about that. There is one slip pocket. Okay. Now, I think the medium has two, one on either side here, the front and the back. The small one has got one. And then my version, I know that some have got like a leather tab where it has the serial number, but I believe mine, because of when it was manufactured, has it. right there. So if you have the zip here, when it's opened, it's underneath this flap here, underneath this flap. Now, I don't know why they did that. I don't know why. I think is it the older ones that have the tab, or is it the new ones? It's probably the new ones that have the tab, and this is the older one. I did get the second hand from eBay, from a reputable site or a reputable seller on eBay with 98% positive and over 10,000 sales. So I was like, okay, yeah. Especially when I started buying designer, I usually would only buy it from like Japanese resellers. So I forget which one is this, but I do remember that it was a really highly rated Japanese seller. Anyway, I was saying to you that whenever I didn't have anything, or whenever I had something in it or heavy enough, it would slouch like that when I don't have the air paper. But I try to still keep it in its shape. So that's why it still looks really good. And I mean, to be honest, I got this December of 2019. Guess when the pandemic hit? March 2020. I had it like 4 months before the pandemic hit. Never really got to use it that much. But have used it enough to be able to give you an opinion on this piece. Okay, right. So inside, by the way, is fabric lined. It's not leather lined. And it's that herringbone canvas that Loewe is famous for. So there we go. Okay. Now, the handles have smooth leather, unlike the grain calfskin on here. This one is smooth, and it's the same for the strap here. Now, what do I think about this bag? This is a beautiful bag. I believe the new Loewe puzzle bags retail, the small ones, according to the MyTheresa website, this retails for $3,850 Australian. In fact, they have this exact one, small leather, $3,850. And that is usually what it would sell here in Australia as well. The medium one here in Australia, I think, was $4,800, if I'm not mistaken. I could be wrong, because I did try to look at the medium one, and I wanted to get the tan version because Loewe's tan is just But I also found it a little too big and too blocky for me, for my frame. So I think this is the perfect size for me. For reference, I am 5'4" and I wear a size US 6 or Australian 10. So, right, what fits in here? My filming camera, my Canon M6 Mark II, actually fits in here with the lens that I use, which is the 22mm. But even if I have the longer lens, that's the 32mm, it still fits in here. It is a little bit of a struggle to get it in and out of the mouth because of the way the mouth is designed, right? But it fits. All of my essentials would fit in here as well. So I use the 19 today, so all of my things are in here. So if I put in here what's on my Chanel 19, or in my Chanel 19, I've got a Nintendo game on there. So this is my medium kirigami, which I use as my catch-all. And I just used this last week, so I know that they all fit. Even if I put it like that way, vertical or horizontal, either way fits fine. Plenty of room. My small kirigami, which I usually put in the slip pocket, tissue paper, sunglasses, sanitizer, and hand cream. Still plenty of space in there, ladies and gents. I can even fit a water bottle in here. Let's try that. Here's an empty water bottle. No bulging, no bulkiness, no distortion. Fits pretty well, right? Anyway, so what do I think about this? Is it worth the price tag? I wouldn't, obviously I didn't buy it brand new, and I don't think I would have, simply because Loewe doesn't really hold its value, I'd say. Like, you would always lose money if you try to resell this. It's not like the Chanel's or the Hermes or the Louis Vuitton where you could actually make money from reselling your pre-loved item. Like, if I sold my Kirigami set, which I bought for $1,000, I could still sell it for $1,500 and make 50% off what the cost is. Anyway, now this comes with a dust bag that also has that herringbone pattern that's inside the bag. Okay, and whenever I don't use my bags, you can probably see here, they will be in dust bags. Usually when I'm filming, I would take them out of their dust bags, but I just couldn't be bothered today. I was like, come on. It's really, really sturdy. The leather is beautiful. I have not had any issues with it. No scratches. The corners are still doing well. Granted that I probably use this under 15 times because, well, pandemic. Yeah, but really, like, even the bottom, it has no feet. Some of the older ones had feet. My version doesn't have feet anymore. I wish they kept it with feet. But even without it, because it is grained calfskin, it doesn't scratch easily. So I have yet to find a scratch on this baby. Nothing really. Alright. Would I recommend it? If you like designer items that are understated, if you like designer items that does not call attention on yourself, this is a really good one. Last week I went to a gathering of the Filipino community here in Sydney, and I carried this, and one of the ladies said to me, "Oh, you have a really nice bag," which is very rare to happen with this Loewe, because very few people that I know in my circle would recognize the brand, would recognize this bag, because again, it's an understated bag. This, by the way, was designed by J.W. Anderson. Okay, so when she said that, she actually said to me, "Ang landi ng bag mo," which is, your bag is really flirty. And I didn't understand it at first why it would be flirty, but I know what she meant. And I was like, yeah, it calls attention when you know what the brand is. But it's not like the Louis Vuitton with all of its monograms, or that, like, whether it's Damier Ebene or Damier Azur or even their Empreinte leather, you know it's Louis Vuitton when you see that. It doesn't have a large CC like the Chanel's do, except for the reissue. Yeah, it's just really understated. I feel safe when I carry this because it doesn't call attention on yourself. It's got the perfect size for me, holds everything that I need and more. So yeah, I would definitely recommend this, and it's probably gonna stay in my collection for a very long time just because I really like it. When I was like in the face of in-your-face monograms, and I think most luxe lovers have that face, I wanted to sell this off, but I held onto it and I said to myself, you know what, there will come a time where you're going to outgrow this monogram phase and you're gonna want something that's not as flashy. And I'm glad I kept this. Yeah, so there we go. Loewe puzzle bag review. Love it, would recommend it. If I don't have this, I would definitely buy it. If I lost this or have to buy it again, I will not hesitate, will not have any second thoughts. I would do so in a heartbeat. Okay. Would I buy it in the same color? Yes. Would I buy it in another color? Also yes. I have actually been stalking the resale market for a tan version of this. but I just don't want to pay the price tag of the resale market at this point, just because it's getting ridiculous, really. And it's not just the Chanel's, it's a lot of the other brands. But anyway, I love this bag. I will definitely recommend that you at least give it a try. Go to a Loewe shop if you have one near you, and the best way to choose the size for you is to actually try it on. Right. Well, that's all I've got to say about this bag. Let me know in the comment section below if you have any questions, comments, violent reactions. Let's launch her. Right. Nice. There you go. If you have any questions, comments, violent reactions on this bag, let me know in the comment section down below. I'll see you all again in the next video.